And we are back. This is video 5 in this series about Painter 2023. And these first videos are the way I set things up. Okay, so we're doing palette drawers now and setting stuff up around the screen that makes it work best for me. And what I do next is I come down these things and make sure that I have them coming up wherever I want them to come up. All right, so this first one here is Save Variant. I'm going to click on that and see that it just pops up Save Variant like this, and I can save the variant. So that's perfect right there in the center. The next one is Brush Selector Panel. Open that up, and what I want to do here is make it into a palette drawer, and we will rename it Brush Selector Panel. Now, I do this every time that we get a new version. Is it totally necessary? No, but it's what I enjoy doing. Now, I think it makes my workflow much faster. I don't want to put this one over here because that's where it is to begin with. And this is something that you can have that stays open. So if I wanted to use that, I would put it over here and let it just cover up some of the stuff that we have. And remember, I put it in place and then click off. And at some point when I save the layout, that will be fixed. Okay, so the next thing is brush calibration. So I would want to pull the brush calibrator out. And you know what? I'm going to pull these three out. I'm going to put brush calibration right next to that. And then I'm going to put Stroke Preview and Dab Preview on top. And we will call this Palette Drawer. Rename. Peaches, get down. Get down. Well, he's laying up there between the monitor and me, so we'll see what happens. Okay, palette drawer, I want to rename it, and we want to rename it General Perform and Calibrate. Now the stroke preview and dab preview are there as well. So we click on that. Now, what's going to open that up? If I were to click on, let's go to another brush. Okay, if I click off on that. Okay, that's not going to open it up. So, but while I've got this open, let's go on and fix it. I'm going to make it a palette drawer. I'm going to rename it, and it is Advanced Brush Controls. Click, and we're going to move it right over here and close it. So what am I going to do with this now? I don't think I need this in a I don't need the mouse. Spacing, stroke jitter, smoother, dab stencil. These are going to be part of another section. So let's just close that. I think I've done what I wanted to do over there. All right, so brush calibration. Now let's go to mirror painting. And we don't need anything with it. And if we go to kaleidoscope, that just changes that. Text. All right, now text, we should have a text, show or hide the text panel. So we want to bring up the text panel and we're going to make it into a palette drawer, rename it text. And it's going to be opening up right up here. And then we will shut it down like that. Okay, so we've got text, shape selection, pin, crop, selection adjuster, transform, and layer adjuster. I think that's all we need from these. So now I want to go to, let's go over here. We know that that's going to open up the brush tool. We know that's the dropper tool. Now let's click on that. Yeah, I don't get an extra thing popping up. I want to click on interactive gradients, and then I'm going to look over here. Let's save changes, X out, show or hide gradient, node panel, edit nodes. Ah, here we go. All right, so I'm going to click on gradients panel and bring that up. And that's going to have the gradients, gradient things, and the gradient nodes. Now, some people would put these with the media, but I'm going to keep it separate because I use a fair amount. And I'm going to leave it just like it is because it has everything I need. So if I come over here and close that, and I want to see any of it, all I have to do is hit one of these. Not that one. Or that one. There we go. Okay, so that opens that up for me. And what else do I have down here that I might want to do something with? Well, if I click on that, it's going to open this up. Now, when I change it, it doesn't change because this is set to pin. And I don't want it to be pin, so I'm going to undo that. And now when I call it up and change the color, start to paint, it's going to go away. So it's not going to be in my way. Clone, that's okay. All of this is okay. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is come up here. We've got a calligraphy grainy edge brush. And I'm going to look at what we've got that pops up here. We've got, let's see, we're in this grainy. We're not in the brush. Here we go. Let's click on the brush. All right, so what I want to do now is click on the brush icon so that I get the brush property bar up here, and this is where I'm going to find the rest of the palette drawers. Okay, so we had opacity palette drawer, and there's that. If I go to size, we have a side panel. Click on it, and there's your size panel. Let me get rid of the opacity panel first. Okay, now I'm going to click on this again, and I'm going to open up the angle panel. And there is another one that I like to use, and we're going to go to advanced technology. And it is the size, angle, spacing. So I want the spacing, I don't want to pull it from there. I want to go to Windows, brush control panels, general, shape, it's media, I think. It must be shape. Yep, there it is. So we're going to go to spacing. All right, so now we have size, angle, and spacing, which is in here, the general brush controls. So I'm going to drag it out like that. And what I want to do is create size, angle, and spacing. like that. Now we're going to go palette drawer, rename, and this will be called size angle. And spacing, or just space for short. Okay, now that one I want to pop up right here under size. So we'll put it right there. Oops. There. Okay, so now we can close that. All right. So we have size, we have opacity. Now, let's click on this. This is Paint Opacity, Use Fluid Paint, Fluid Paint Panel. Let's open that up. And Use Paint Layering Panel. Let's open that up. Oh, it's down here already on it. Okay, that's good. I needed to keep it on it, though. Let's do this. Put it down like that. And we're going to change this palette drawer, rename it, and it's going to be Fluid Paint. Say OK. Now the Fluid Paint, I want that to be over here. The only ones I want over here would be Opacity and Size, that group. I'll close that down. Okay, so Paper Selector, if we hit Grain Panel, we're going to get Opacity Grain. If we hit where was I? Doesn't matter. Okay. Oh shoot, I'm 12 minutes. This is taking a long time. Well, you know what, you can skim through this stuff, I think, probably as easy as not. So let me save this and close Painter and start a new video. So we're going to go to Layout, Save Layout, SKIP, apostrophe S, 2023. Okay, yes, replace it. We can close that for the moment. And we will close Painter. Okay, I'll see you in the next video.